Let's have a look at the types of letter of credit. Now, types of letter of credit would basically depend upon the method of payment, whether the LC is revocable or not, whether any middleman is involved or not, or whether any other transactions is involved or not. Okay, so it depends upon all this. Now, the basic classifications what we can have is, number one, irrevocable LC. It does not mean we are going to have a revocable LC. That concept was removed way back in 2007. It means now all LCs that are opened are irrevocable in nature. It means you cannot, you can neither amend nor cancel the LC without the express agreement of all parties to the LC. So that's what we mean by irrevocable LC. It means when we say all parties, the applicant, issuing bank, beneficiary, all three minimum should agree. Then we can also have two or three other classifications or types of LC. One, we have site LC. Site LC is a case where the supplier is not giving, the seller is not giving any credit to the buyer. It means the buyer is opening LC in favor of seller just to get his confidence, so that he can send the goods, because the goods have to travel a longer distance and the seller has a fear whether the buyer would pay or not, say without credit itself, because there is going to be a transit period and whether he will pay or not, so there is a fear. So seller has insisted on LC and buyer had opened LC in favor of seller, and that is a site LC. So in site LC, what is going to happen? The buyer's bank would open the LC, and by the time it reaches, that is by the time it is cited to the bank, the payment has to be made. Okay, it means if the seller is going to show the documents which are prescribed in letter of credit which is opened by the buyer in favor of the seller, and if the seller is going to show all the documents, say like invoice, say the transit documents, shipment documents, and insurance, whatever that is stipulated, and if everything is shown, then payment at site should happen. So here the payment is happening on or upon presentation of documents. Even though we say site, it would take minimum say 7 days, or it goes like 7 plus 7 plus 7, 21 days. Okay, so that's about site LC. Then there is something known as use on LC, where the seller is permitting a certain credit period to the buyer. So here the buyer would open the LC, it would reach the seller would showcase the documents, okay, and the payment for the seller would happen only after the usance period plus these say that minimum grace period, or that 7 plus 7 plus 7 days. Okay, so credit period is offered by the seller, payment is going to happen on a prefixed date. Then we also have two other kind of LCs, inland LCs and foreign LCs. That's based on the geography. The LCs which are issued within the country we call as inland, and LC that are used in import export transaction we call them as foreign LC.